गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. सो फ्रॉम नाउ विल डिस्कस विल स्टार्ट विद द इंडिविजुअल वायरल फैमिलीज. टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल अबाउट द जनरल वायरोलॉजी, स्टार्टिंग विद द हिस्ट्री ऑफ वायरोलॉजी. देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन, नॉमेनक्लेचर, टैक्सोनॉमी ऑफ वायरसेस. देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द रेप्लिकेशन साइकिल ऑफ वायरसेस एंड ऑल अबाउट वायरल जेनेटिक्स, द जेनेटिक एंड नॉन जेनेटिक इंटरेक्शंस ऑफ वायरसेस. नाउ विल स्टार्ट विद द वायरल फैमिलीज. First, we'll start with the RNA viruses. I'll be taking all the viruses that are infecting domestic animals, and the viruses infecting birds will be taken up by Dr. Sunita. So today I'll take up this virus, picorna viruses. We'll start with the picorna viruses. Now let's start with the introduction first. Now members of the family Picornaviridae, they are very small in size, and they belong to group 4 Baltimore classification system. We have discussed in general virology about the Baltimore classification system, which is the most widely accepted classification system. So picornaviruses, they belong to group 4, and group 4 mein aate hain positive sense RNA viruses. RNA viruses mein bhi we have some categories like positive sense RNA viruses, then we have got another group with negative sense RNA viruses. Then we have RNA viral families with reverse transcriptase as enzyme. So these picorna viruses, they belong to group 4 Baltimore classification system. Now picorna viruses, in Spanish the pico word means very small in size. So these picorna viruses are small in size. They have icosahedral symmetry, they are non-enveloped, and they contain a molecule of single-stranded RNA. So these were the features of picornaviruses. If we talk about the size, virions, they are 30 nanometer in diameter. Viruses ki size range ki baat karein, to they range from 18 to 20 nanometers to 300 nanometers in size. So approximately 30 nanometers in diameter, they are very close to the smallest virus in the family. So they are small in size. Now the capsid is composed of 60 identical subunits, each containing 4 major proteins, that is VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4. The VP4 protein, it is located on the inner surface of the capsid. These are very important proteins from your examination point of view, and further for your future competitive exams. These proteins, VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4, you must know the proteins that are present on the capsid. So I have mentioned only the important names. So here for picorna viruses, you have got these 4 major proteins, that is VP1, 2, 3 and 4. Out of all these, the VP4 protein, it is located on the inner surface of the capsid. Then viral replication, it occurs in the cytoplasm, in membrane associated complexes, and the infection is usually cytolytic. Remember here one point that I guess I have mentioned that in general virology also, that jitne bhi RNA viruses hain, they replicate in the cytoplasm, with I guess few exceptions are there, but RNA viruses, they replicate in the cytoplasm, and DNA viruses jitne bhi hain, they replicate in the nucleus of the cell. Now these picorna viruses, they are resistant to ether, chloroform and non-ionic detergents. Now this family, Picornaviridae family, it comprises of 6 genera, that is enterovirus, rhinovirus, cardiovirus, aphthovirus, hepatovirus and pericovirus. Now out of all these, the 4 genera, that is aphthovirus, enterovirus, cardiovirus and hepatovirus, they contain the viruses of veterinary significance. So we'll only take up the viruses which are important from for your veterinary point of view. So we'll only take up those viruses. So do remember the classification, that all these genera, all these names, enterovirus, rhinovirus, cardiovirus, all these come under your Picornaviridae family. So we'll discuss only the important ones. Rhinovirus, I guess you must have heard this name, rhinovirus, which causes common cold, which is associated with the common cold in humans. This is coming under this family, Picornaviridae. So do remember that rhinovirus, basically it's a virus infecting humans, but it can be considered as a minor pathogen in cattle as well. So these viruses, they come under this Picorna Viridae family. Then we have a very important member of this family is Aphthous virus, which causes FMD. That's the major and the most significant disease of domestic animals, especially your bovines, that is foot and mouth disease, FMD, very important for you people. So that a virus causing FMD is your Aphthous virus, and it comes under Picorna viridae family. So today we'll be taking up this FMD. We'll be discussing all about the Aphthous virus and FMD. Now see this chart, the viruses which are of veterinary importance, which comes under this family Picorna viridae. See all the genera and the disease or the viruses that are that come under this genus. Now family is your Picorna viridae. If we talk about the first genus, that is Aphthous virus, it causes foot and mouth disease virus. It contains foot and mouth disease virus, which causes FMD. It has got 7 serotypes and many subtypes are also there. Then next genus is Tissue virus. Tissue virus causes porcine enterovirus. इसमें जो वायरस आता है दैट्स पोर्साइन एंटीरो वायरस वन. इट्स अ वायरस इन्फेक्टिंग पोर्साइन्स और स्वाइन स्पेशली. देन वी हैव गॉट अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट मेंबर ऑफ दिस फैमिली इज योर एंटीरो वायरस, विच मेनली कॉजेज स्वाइन वेसिकुलर डिजीजेज. देन वी हैव पोर्साइन एंटीरो वायरसेस रेंजिंग फ्रॉम 2 to 11. देन एवियन एंटीरो वायरसेस, बोवाइन एंटीरो वायरसेस, दे ऑल कम अंडर योर Picorna viridae फैमिली. देन वी हैव अनदर मेंबर कार्डियो वायरस, which causes which contains encephalomyocarditis virus. Then we have hepatovirus, which causes avian encephalomyelitis disease, very important disease of poultry. So which it, this is caused by hepatovirus, and it also comes under your family Picorna viridae. Now first we'll be taking up this very important disease, which is your foot and mouth disease. So the first member is your Aphthous virus. They cause foot and mouth disease. You must know the causative agent. So first and the foremost thing is you must know the causative agent of a disease. Very important for your objectives. So Aphthous viruses, they cause foot and mouth disease, and these viruses come under your family Picorna viridae. I am repeating this again and again because you need to remember these, the families and the members of these families and the disease which they cause. Sabse pehle detail mein jaane se pehle you need to know the family, the name of the family, the members that come under that family, and the disease, particular disease they cause. So FMD is very important and highly significant disease of domestic animals. Aphthous viruses which cause FMD, they are unstable at pH values below 6.5. So they are very unstable at low pH. This is a highly contagious disease of even-toed ungulates, and it is characterized by fever and formation of vesicles on the epithelial surfaces. So basically FMD, it's a highly contagious disease. Agar ek animal ko hoti hai to it is very contagious, pure ke pure herd gets infected. So highly contagious disease hai, particularly yahan pe sabse important cheez to be note down here is that it is a disease of even-toed ungulates. That means your all these cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat, they all are susceptible, highly susceptible to FMD. And another important point is that your FMD is a list A disease of major economic importance internationally because of, on account of its rapid spread and the dramatic economic losses which it causes in the susceptible animals. Pura ka pura farm, it gets contaminated, or there are dramatic economic losses occurring in the farms. So that's why it's an important disease of major importance internationally as well. So it is a list A disease. Do remember this. OI has generated certain list, certain diseases which comes under list A, list B and list C. So do remember, you have I guess you have studied that in your public health lectures, that FMD, it comes under list A. So do remember this. Then jitne bhi isolates hain FMD ke, FMD virus, they are grouped in 7 serotypes. Very important. FMD virus has got 7 serotypes, which are recognized as separate species with different geographical distribution. So these are the 7 isolates or the 7 serotypes. In isolates bhi bolte hain, and serotypes bhi bolte hain. So there are basically 7-0 types of FMDV. This is again another important objective for you people, that FMD viruses, it is divided into, or it's grouped into 7 serotypes. And these 7 serotypes are your OA, C, Asia 1, SAT 1, SAT 2 and SAT 3. Now see this, this is the distribution, geographical distribution, that in which country, which strain or which serotype is prevalent. Like for example, serotypes OA and C, they are distributed in South America mainly. OAC, they are also distributed in your Eastern European countries. Then OAC, SAT1, SAT2 and SAT3, they are distributed in Africa. This SAT1 is your South African territory 1, 2 and 3. So this is mainly distributed in Africa. OAC and Asia 1 is particularly distributed in Asia. So you note here that OAC, these are the major serotypes which are prevalent in almost all the countries, all the continents. So OAC are of major importance. Then Asia 1 is present in Asia only. SAT1, SAT2, SAT3, they are present in Africa. And rest all the serotypes OAC, they are present in mostly almost all the countries and continents. Now, if we talk about these serotypes, the infection with one serotype, it does not confer immunity against the other serotypes. Okay. A large number of subtypes, they are also recognized within each serotype. So each serotype, there are 7 serotypes, and each serotype, it is containing further large number of subtypes. Now, if we go for nucleotide sequencing of the VP1 gene, I've told you there are 4 genes present in the capsid. They are basically the structural proteins of your picornaviruses. VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4. Now if we go for sequencing, the nucleotide sequencing of the VP1 gene, it encodes for your capsid protein. It is used for comparing an isolate from an outbreak with other isolates of the same serotype in order to determine the possible source of infection. So this has got very important role. These capsid proteins are very important for comparing an isolate, especially during an outbreak. We need to compare these isolates with other isolates of the same serotype in order to determine the possible source of infection. Now, if we talk about the risk group, the virus can affect human beings. So, don't remember, the virus is having zoonotic importance. The FMD virus is zoonotic in nature. It can affect human beings. But since the infection is uncommon, FMD is not considered as a public health problem. That's not so common. But still, remember this. This is a zoonotic virus. It can also affect humans. Zoonotic viruses are those which can be transferred from animals to humans. So this virus has the tendency to affect humans. But the infection is uncommon. Now, if we talk about the classification system of FMD, it comes under Baltimore group 4, that is, it is a positive sense RNA virus. Order is your nidovirales, family is picornaviridae, genus we are talking about is aphthous virus, species is your foot and mouth disease virus. The disease is your foot and mouth disease, but if we talk about the species, genus is your aphthous virus, but species is FMD virus. And if we talk about the type species, we have got O strain. The major and the most important strain of FMD virus is your strain O. Now next we'll talk about the replication cycle of aphthous virus or FMD virus. FMD virus, it's an RNA virus, and RNA viruses jitne bhi hain, they replicate in the cytoplasm. So replication occurs in the cytoplasm and is very rapid. It replicates very rapidly. So the replication cycle, it occurs very fast and it is completed between 5 to 10 hours. So it's very rapid in replication. That means its cycle, it's completed in almost 5 to 10 hours. So very rapidly multiplying and replicating virus. Protein synthesis jitni bhi hai in the virus infected cell, it declines sharply almost to nil level, and this is called shut off. Replication cycle mein ek term is used here, that is your shut off. Shut off means during the replication, if protein synthesis, it is occurring in the virus during replication, okay? Protein synthesis in the virus infected cell, it declines sharply, almost to the nil level in between the replication. And this mechanism is called your shut off mechanism. Now, since the genome, it is your positive sense genome, it is immediately translated into the polyprotein, which is cleaved into enzymes that are required for genome replication, and into the structural protein by protease enzymes. आई गेस इन जनरल वायरोलॉजी आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट, आई मीन इन शॉर्ट आई हैव टोल्ड यू और डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रेप्लिकेशन स्ट्रैटेजी, आई मीन ट्रांसक्रिप्शन एंड ट्रांसलेशन स्ट्रैटेजी ऑफ ऑल द बाल्टीमोर ग्रुप्स. सो जितने भी पॉजिटिव सेंस आरएनए वायरसेस हैं उनका पॉजिटिव सेंस आरएनए इज़ डायरेक्टली एक्टिंग एज अ टेम्पलेट फॉर द ट्रांसलेशन मैकेनिज्म. सो दिस इज दिस आरएनए, इट सिंस द जीनोम इज पॉजिटिव सेंस इट इज़ इमीडिएटली ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू योर प्रोटीन. देन दिस प्रोटीन इज़ रिक्वायर्ड, ऑल ऑब्वियसली दैट प्रोटीन विल बी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एंजाइमेटिक फॉर्मेशन और एंजाइम्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर जीनोम रेप्लिकेशन एंड इनटू द ऑल्सो इनटू द स्ट्रक्चरल प्रोटीन्स which are required for the build-up of the viral capsid. Now, one such product is your RNA-dependent RNA polymerase enzymes. During replication, these enzymes are very important for replication. Here, since it is a positive sense RNA virus, it has got RNA-dependent RNA polymerase enzyme, which copies the genomic RNA to produce a negative sense strand. So, this negative sense strand replicative intermediate and from which this positive sense RNA are produced. These positive sense RNAs, they are packed into the capsid. The RNA is packed into preformed capsids. Hence, empty capsids or defective capsids, they are common in all the coronavirus infections. I guess you need not to go into such details, but still you need to know the replicative cycle. That is, it has got a positive sense mRNA, which is directly translated into the proteins. And from these proteins, the capsid is formed. स्ट्रक्चरल प्रोटीन्स भी होते हैं एंड कुछ फंक्शनल प्रोटीन्स भी होते हैं फ्रॉम विच सर्टेन एंजाइम्स आर फॉर्म्ड. सो हेंस एम्प्टी कैप्सिड्स दे आर कॉमन इन दिस कोरोना वायरल इन्फेक्शंस. दे आर रिलीज्ड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस द रिलीज ऑफ द वायरस फ्रॉम द साइटोप्लाज्म अकर्स व्हेन द सेल लाइसेस. सो दिस इज अ प्री प्रोग्रामड इवेंट विच अकर्स अ सेट टाइम आफ्टर द सीजेशन ऑफ हाउस कीपिंग मैक्रोमोलिक्यूल सिंथेसिस इज शट ऑफ. Now this was the replication cycle of FMD virus. Now these are the sequence of events that takes place in a cell which is infected with your FMD virus. Now time after infection is, suppose after 1 to 2 hours, the event occurring is there is a sharp decrease in host cell macromolecular synthesis. Now 2.5 to 3 hours mein there is start of viral protein synthesis. Then 3 to 4 hours ke baad permeabilization of plasma membrane is there. 4 to 6 hours के बाद वायरस असेंबली इज़ देयर एंड 6 to 10 hours में लाइसिस ऑफ द सेल एंड रिलीज ऑफ वायरस पार्टिकल्स इन इज देयर. सो दीज आर ऑल द इवेंट्स एंड यू नोट दिस हेयर दैट रेप्लिकेटिव साइकिल इज सो रैपिड दैट ऑल द रेप्लिकेशन साइकिल इट कम्प्लीट्स इन ऑलमोस्ट 6 to 10 hours. सो दीज आर द इवेंट्स अकरिंग ड्यूरिंग योर रेप्लिकेशन साइकिल. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द कल्टिवेशन, वायरल कल्टिवेशन. So, you know, like for example, if you want to grow or culture bacteria, the samples, they are inoculated into the culture media, like your nutrient agar, blood agar, you grow the bacteria there. But viruses cannot grow in that media because viruses, they require the living cells for their replication. So, unhe aap media pe grow nahi kar sakte. So, virus cultivation ke liye, I guess you have been taught the cultivation of viruses. Viruses can be cultivated in embryonated chicken eggs, then in live cell cultures and also in lab animals. So if we particularly talk about the FMD virus, we can cultivate it in cell cultures. Like the virus, it grows well in cell cultures. The cell cultures which are commonly used for FMD virus are primary bovine thyroid cells, primary pig, calf or lamb kidney cells and cell lines such as BHK21, that is baby hamster kidney, and IBRS2 cell lines. These are all the cell lines for FMD virus cultivation. Then the cytopathic effects, they are produced in 24 to 48 hours. So jab bhi aap cell cultures or cell lines mein cultivate karenge viruses ko, ultimately cytopathic effects, they are visualized and then you can go for the identification of the type of virus present. Then also next is you can also cultivate the viruses in lab animals. Lab animals mein mostly unweaned mice is the most suitable lab animal for the cultivation of FMDV. Mice of 2 to 7 days old, they are commonly used for the cultivation of these viruses. So this was about the cultivation. Then we'll talk about the host which are affected by FMD. Now jitne bhi cloven footed domestic animals hain or wild animals hain, they are primarily affected, like bovines, cattle, zebus cattle, domestic buffaloes, yaks, sheep, goats, swine, and jitne bhi wild ruminants, and they are severely affected. Then we have members of the family Camelidae. They have low susceptibility. And other susceptible species are your hedgehogs, armadillos, nutrias, elephants, capybaras, rats and mice. So mainly jitne bhi cloven footed animals hain, whether they are domestic or wild, they are mostly affected by this FMD. Then if we talk about the distribution, I have stated earlier the distribution, geographical distribution, all the serotypes. Let's see, FMD virus, it is widely distributed throughout the world, but mostly endemic areas, they were Asia, Africa and parts of South America. Most of the European countries, they are generally free from FMD, barring few outbreaks. Now, countries belonging to the European Union, they have stopped FMD vaccination. North and Central America, Australia, New Zealand, Japan and the British Isles, they are free from FMD. So this was about the geographical distribution of FMD. Then if we talk about the transmission, how this virus is transmitted, FMD virus, it spreads by following methods. These are basically the means of spread or transmission of the viruses. The virus can be spread through direct or indirect contact with the infected animals, the first and foremost thing. Then through aerosols also. From infected animals, jitne bhi aerosols hai, FMD can be transmitted from aerosols as well. And then feeding contaminated garbage like meat, milk, blood, glands, bones, cheese, etc. Then contact with the contaminated objects like hands, footwear, clothing. Then through artificial insemination as well. Then contaminated biological substances such as hormones. Through inanimate objects like a person in contact with the infected animal can have sufficient FMD virus in his or her respiratory tract for 24 hours. So it can serve as a source of infection for all other susceptible animals. Now also as airborne, especially in the temperate zones for a distance of up to 60 km overland and 300 km by the sea. So these are various transmission routes of FMD virus. Then in an outbreak of FMD, the roles of three primary hosts in transmission are as follows. This is a very important point for your objectives, that for FMD, sheep acts as a maintenance host, pig act as an amplifier host and cattle is your indicator host. So FMD mein indicator host ki baat karein toh cattle is the indicator, pigs are the amplifier host and sheep they act as maintenance host. जो भी आपका एम्पलीफायर होस्ट है, देर इज़ नो कैरियर स्टेट प्रेजेंट इन द एम्पलीफायर होस्ट, बट एम्पलीफायर क्या करेगा, इट विल सिक्रीट वायरस आई गेस मोर देन 1000 टाइम्स देन कैटल विच इज़ योर इंडिकेटर होस्ट. सो कैटल इज़ योर इंडिकेटर होस्ट, शीप आर द एम्पलीफायर होस्ट विच सिक्रीट वायरस मोर देन 1000 टाइम्स. एंड शीप गोट दे एक्ट एज मेंटेनेंस होस्ट जिनमें सब क्लिनिकल इन्फेक्शन carrier state is also there, so they are your maintenance host. When sheep or goats they become infected with FMD virus, the disease may not be diagnosed for a longer time because signs and lesions they are very mild, but during this time the animals will be producing infectious aerosols, contaminating fomites and spreading the virus by contact. Now FMD in pigs, it spreads very rapidly, for they produce 30 to 100 times more virus in aerosols than sheep or cattle. FMD in pigs, it spreads very rapidly. For they produce 30 to 100 times more virus in the aerosols than sheep or cattle. An infected pig, it can produce 100 million infectious doses per day. So your pig is the amplifier host. That's why it's an amplifier host, because it produces 30 to 100 times more viruses in aerosols. Now when cattle, they are infected with FMD virus, signs and lesions, they usually develop more rapidly and are more severe than in pigs, sheep or goats. If cattle, sheep and pigs, they are exposed together, cattle will usually get sick first because it is the most susceptible animal to FMD virus. Now some animals, particularly recovered cattle, can be the carriers of FMD virus. Most of the ruminant species harbor the virus in their pharyngeal tissues. Mostly ye virus ruminants mein kahan present hota hai? Pharynx mein unke. Pharynx mein replicate aur multiply karte hai for a longer period. So mostly ruminants mein they harbor this virus in their pharyngeal tissues. Do remember this. This is again an important point. Aur isse pehle jo maine bataya usme, this is the important point डू रिमेंबर, शीप इज़ अ मेंटेनेंस होस्ट फॉर FMD वायरस, पिग इज़ अ एम्पलीफायर एंड कैटल इज़ योर इंडिकेटर स्पीशीज. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड ऑफ द वायरस, इन एन एक्सपेरिमेंटली इन्फेक्टेड कैटल द इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड इज़ यूजली 24 to 48 hours. In other conditions, the incubation period is 2 to 14 days. In pigs, the incubation period is as short as 1 to 3 days. So basically, the incubation period is kam hi hai, it's 24 to 48 hours. And then if we talk about the morbidity and mortality, the morbidity is 100% and mortality is usually less than 1%. But in young animals and with certain isolates, mortality can be high. कुछ ऐसे specific isolates की बात करें जिनका mortality rate high है, and in young animals particularly mortality can be high, but morbidity is 100%. Now let's start with the symptoms of these virus. We'll discuss individually, in individual species, what are the peculiar signs and symptoms. Like first we'll talk about the symptoms present in cattle. The initial signs of FMD are pyrexia, there will be high fever, 39.4 से 40.6 डिग्री सेल्सियस हाई फीवर इज देयर, डलनेस, एनोरेक्सिया एंड देयर इज़ फॉल इन मिल्क प्रोडक्शन. नाउ दीज साइंस दे आर फॉलोड बाय एक्सेसिव सैलिवेशन, ड्रूलिंग, सीरियस नेजल डिस्चार्जेस, शेकिंग, किकिंग ऑफ द फीट और लेमनेस एंड वेसिकल और ब्लिस्टर फॉर्मेशन. नाउ दीज आर द इनिशियल साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स. द साइट ऑफ प्रेडिलेक्शन फॉर वेसिकल्स मेनली इसमें आपको देखने को मिलेगा दैट वेसिकल्स आर फॉर्म्ड. विजुअल लीजन्स की बात करें तो वेसिकल्स आर फॉर्म्ड ऑन द टंग, डेंटल पैड, गम्स, सॉफ्ट पैलेट, नॉस्ट्रल्स, मजल, इंट्रा डिजिटल स्पेस, कोरोनरी बैंड एंड टीथ्स. एंड देन आफ्टर वेसिकल फॉर्मेशन ड्रूलिंग में भी मोर मार्क्ड, ड्रूलिंग ऑफ सलाइवा इज मोर मार्क्ड इन एनिमल्स, इन कैटल एस्पेशली. एंड नेजल डिस्चार्ज इज ऑल्सो देयर देयर एंड इन सम केसेज लेमनेस इज ऑल्सो देयर. If we talk about the pregnant cows may abort and young calves may die without developing any vesicle. So the course of an FMD infection is 2 to 3 weeks. Secondary infection may delay the recovery. So the chances of secondary infection are also there. And if we talk about the lactating animal, they may not recover to the pre-infection production because of damage to the secretory tissues. Secretory tissues also get damaged because of this FMD virus. So lactating animal may not recover because of this damage to the secretory tissues. Now complications bhi hain kuch FMD virus ki further. These include tongue erosions, super infection of the lesions, hoof deformation might be there, mastitis and permanent impairment of milk production might occur. Then myocarditis, abortion, death of the young animals. Young animals mein mostly death hoti hai because of this myocarditis. Permanent loss of weight is there, loss of heat control, and such animals they are called as panters, hairy panters. So these are the sequel or complication of this FMD virus in cattle. Young ones mein death can occur because of this myocarditis. And rest, these are all the signs and symptoms you have seen in pregnant animal, in lactating animal, initial signs and symptoms, and jo bhi sites for vesicle formation hai, we have discussed here. So do remember these signs and symptoms of FMD in cattle, very important. Then if we talk about sheep and goat, clinical signs, if they occur, they tend to be very mild and they may include dullness, fever and small vesicles or erosions on the dental pad, lips, gums and tongue. Mild lameness may be the only sign. Sheep and goat mein mostly aapko lameness dekhne ko milegi, so that might be indicative of FMD virus. In lame animals, there may be vesicles or erosion on the coronary band or in the interdigital space. Infected animals, they may abort. Abortion is also a sign of this FMD virus. Nursing lambs may die without showing any clinical signs. So mainly sheep and goat ki baat karein to clinical sign most prevalent is your lameness. Okay, then another species is pigs. Pigs mein hum signs and symptoms ki baat karein to initial signs are your fever, anorexia, reluctance to move and scream when they are forced to move. The signs are followed by vesicles. Vesicle formation is the peculiar feature of FMD virus, and mostly these are seen on your coronary band, heels, interdigital spaces and on the snout in case of pigs. जो भी माउथ लीजन्स हैं दे आर नॉट सो कॉमन इन पिग्स, एंड वेन दे अकर दे आर स्मॉलर एंड ऑफ शॉर्टर ड्यूरेशन दैन इन कैटल, एंड देन दे टेंड टू बी अ ड्राई टाइप ऑफ लीजन्स. अगर पिग्स में वेसिकल्स होंगे माउथ में पहले तो दे आर नॉट टू कॉमन, एंड दूसरा अगर होंगे भी तो दे आर स्मॉलर इन साइज एज कम्पेयर टू कैटल एंड दे टेंड टू बी ड्राई टाइप लीजर्स. देयर इज़ नो ड्रूलिंग ऑफ सलाइवा इन देयर, बट सोज दे मे ऑल्सो अबॉर्ट. अबॉर्शन इज ऑल्सो अ साइन सीन इन ऑल द एनिमल्स बिकॉज ऑफ FMD वायरस. पिगलेट्स दे मे डाई विदाउट शोइंग एनी क्लिनिकल साइंस. सो यंग वंस में इट्स अ डेडली वायरस. मॉर्टिलिटी इज हाई इन केस ऑफ यंग वंस, नॉट इन केस ऑफ एडल्ट्स. सो दीज वर द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स इन ऑल दीज स्पीशीज. देन विल टॉक अबाउट द लीजन्स, द पिक्यूलर लीजन्स प्रेजेंट इन द इंडिविजुअल स्पीशीज. First, we'll talk about the lesions in cattle. The diagnostic lesions, they are single or multiple vesicles ranging from 2 to 10 centimeter, and these can occur at all the sites of predilection. Now, gross lesions, hum pehle tongue pe dekh lete hain. The lesions usually progress in the following manner on the tongue. Sabse pehle, a small blanched wheatish area develops in the epithelium. Then fluid, kuch fluid hota that fills the area, and a vesicle or a blister is formed. Then this vesicle enlarges and it may coalesce with the adjacent ones. Then after collision and when this enlarges, it gets ruptured. Now vesicular covering sloughs, leaving an eroded or red area is there. Then a gray fibrinous coating form over the eroded area. And then this coating becomes yellow, brown or green. These are the gross lesions and how these lesions progress on the tongue. Then epithelium, finally it is restored, but the line of demarcation, it remains. The line, then gradually it fades. Occasionally, the dry FMD lesions, they develop. Instead of forming a vesicle, the fluid is apparently lost as it forms, and the upper layers of the epithelium, they become more necrotic and discolored. The lesion, therefore, appears necrotic rather than vesicular. Now, these were your lesion and their progression on the tongue. अब फीट पे कौन से ग्रॉस लीजन्स आपको देखने को मिलेंगे. द वेसिकल्स, वेसिकल्स आर फॉर्म्ड ऑलमोस्ट इन ऑल दीज एरियाज, ऑल दीज साइट्स. नाउ द वेसिकल्स इन द इंटर डिजिटल्स, फीट में मोस्टली जो वेसिकल्स दिखेंगे दैट विल बी इन द इंटर डिजिटल स्पेसेस, एंड दे आर यूजुअली लार्ज बिकॉज ऑफ द स्ट्रेस ऑन द एपिथीलियम कॉज्ड बाय द मूवमेंट एंड वेट. वेट सारा का सारा कहाँ पे है, फीट पे एनिमल का. तो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वेट एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट मूवमेंट देर इज स्ट्रेस ऑन द एपिथीलियम, जिसकी वजह से वेसिकल यूजली यहाँ पर जो देखेंगे हम, दे विल बी लार्जर वेसिकल्स इन द इंटर डिजिटल स्पीसेज. नाउ द लीजन्स एट द कोरोनरी बैंड, दे एट फर्स्ट अपीयर्स ब्लास्ट, देन देयर इज सेपरेशन ऑफ द स्किन एंड हॉर्न. नाउ वैन द हीलिंग अकर्स, न्यू हॉर्न इज फॉर्म्ड, बट अ लाइन रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम द कोरोनाइटिस इज सीन ऑन द वॉल ऑफ द रूफ. दिस इज हाउ द ग्रॉस लीजन्स दे अपियर ऑन द फीट. Then another is the gross cardiac and skeletal lesions. Animals that die, they have grayish or yellowish streaking in the myocardium. There is degeneration and necrosis. And these findings, they are known as tiger heart. Another important point for you people is tiger heart appearance, which is a peculiar feature of FMD virus. Mostly in the animals which are dying or which are dead. Dead animals, mein agar aap dekhen, tigroid heart appearance is there in the myocardium. I have told you that young ones mostly die of because of myocarditis as a result of this FMD virus. They mostly die of this myocarditis, and unme peculiar feature is that tiger heart appearance is there. They have grayish or yellowish streaks in the myocardium. That's why it is referred to as tiger heart appearance. Then if we talk about the lesions in sheep and goat, lesions in the mouth and vesicles on the coronary band may be few, small and difficult to find. Animals that die may have a grayish or yellowish streaking in the myocardium with degeneration and necrosis, that is tiger heart. So tigroid heart or tiger heart appearance can be also visualized in sheep and goat. This is also a lesion present in sheep and goats, and mostly jo inke lesions mouth and vesicles on the corona, they may be few. कोरोनरी बैंड पे जो भी दोज वेसिकल्स विल बी फ्यू, स्मॉल एंड डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड, जो कि पिक्यूलियर होते हैं इन केस ऑफ कैटल. एंड इफ़ यू टॉक अबाउट द लीजन्स इन पिग्स, जो भी वेसिकल्स बनेंगे ऑन द स्नाउट, दे कैन बी लार्ज एंड दे आर फिल्ड विद क्लियर और ब्लडी फ्लूइड. माउथ लीजन्स, दे आर यूजली द ड्राई टाइप लीजन्स एंड दे अपेयर एज नेक्रोटिक एपिथीलियम. एंड द फीट लीजन्स, दे आर यूजली सिवियर एंड द हूफ कैन बिकम डिटैच्ड. Animals that die may have grayish or yellowish streaking in the myocardium, same that tiger heart appearance is also present in the pigs as well. बट इनमें मोस्टली वेसिकल्स जो बनते हैं पिग्स में दे आर फाउंड ऑन द योर स्नाउट एंड दे आर लार्ज एंड फिल्ड विद क्लियर और ब्लडी फ्लूइड इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन दीज पिग्स एंड माउथ लीजन्स आर यूजली ड्राई टाइप. सो दीज वर ऑल द लीजन्स प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट स्पीशीज. नाउ नेक्स्ट विल मूव ऑन टू द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ FMD वायरस. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द डायग्नोसिस वी हैव गॉट फील्ड डायग्नोसिस एंड वी हैव गॉट लैब डायग्नोसिस. फील्ड में डायग्नोज करना हो तो इट इज़ ऑब्वियसली प्रेजेंट ऑन द करेक्टरिस्टिक सिम्टम्स प्रेजेंट इन द स्पीशीज. फील्ड में जब भी आप केसेस देखेंगे यू विल फर्स्ट गो फॉर द विजुअलाइजेशन ऑफ द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स दैट अपेयर इन द एनिमल. सो फील्ड डायग्नोसिस के लिए मेनली इंपॉर्टेंट इज यू गो फॉर विजुअलाइजिंग द करेक्टरिस्टिक सिम्टम्स ऑफ FMD वायरस. FMD शुड बी कंसिडर्ड वेन एवर सेलाइवेशन एंड लेमनेस अकर साइमल्टेनियसली एंड अ वेसिकुलर लीजन इज सीन और सस्पेक्टेड. सो मेन अभी तक आपने जितने भी साइंस सिम्टम्स एंड लीजन्स देखे उसमें सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट जो साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स ऑफ फील्ड पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से देखेंगे फील्ड डायग्नोसिस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से दे विल बी योर ड्रूलिंग ऑफ सिलाइवा. लेमनेस इज ऑल्सो देयर एंड वेसिकुलर लीजन्स आर देयर. सो दैट विल बी हाईली सस्पेक्टेड ऑफ योर FMD. इन पिग्स शीप एंड गोट FMD शुड बी कंसिडर्ड वेन एनिमल्स हैव सोर फीट. Vesicular lesion is suspected or both cases should be there. So this is about your field diagnosis. So field mein diagnose karna ho to you need to go for visualization of signs and symptoms, peculiar signs and symptoms which include salivation, lameness and vesicular lesions. Then if we talk about the lab diagnosis mein you will go for isolation, but isolation and identification, and these are the preferred क्लिनिकल मटीरियल. सबसे पहले लैब डायग्नोसिस में आपके पास क्या आएगा सैम्पल. तो सैम्पल कुड बी योर वेसिकुलर फ्लूइड, एपिथीलियम कवरिंग अ वेसिकल, फ्लैप्स ऑफ एपिथीलियल टिश्यू विच आर स्टिल अटैच टू दैट. देन यू कैन ऑल्सो गो फॉर ब्लड सैम्पलिंग 5 ml ऑफ ब्लड विद एंटीकोगुलेंट ड्यूरिंग द वायरेमिक फेज. दैट कुड ऑल्सो बी अ सस्पेक्टेड और यूजफुल क्लिनिकल मटीरियल. अब डेड एनिमल से अगर आपको सैम्पल लेना हो तो सैम्पल कुड बी एपिथीलियल लीजन्स, lymph nodes, thyroid, adrenal gland, kidney and heart. Specimens that are placed in ice, सबसे पहले viral specimens जितने भी हैं they should be placed in ice and they should be delivered to a laboratory within 24 hours. Immediately viral samples को you need to transport them to the laboratory within 24 hours and they should definitely be placed on ice. Now isolation should be attempted in primary bovine thyroid cells, primary pig, cow for lamb kidney cells and cell lines such as BHK-21, and all these cell lines may cytopathic effect that appears after 24 to 48 hours, and then the presence of virus should be confirmed by your serological test like ELISA or PCR which are most suited for these for the FMD virus. Now appropriate serological tests, they include ELISA and complement fixation test CFT. The preferred test for FMD is your ELISA. Very important objective for you people is the preferred and the most suited or gold standard test bhi hum bol sakte hain for FMD virus is your ELISA. So do remember this, the test which is most suited for FMD diagnosis is your ELISA lab mein, which is very sensitive and specific test and it is available in kit form. Then PCR is also, the PCR has been polymerase chain reaction, it has been adapted for the amplification of genome fragments of FMD virus. Then we can go for demonstration of specific antibody by virus neutralization or by ELISA that can be used to confirm a diagnosis in unvaccinated animals. Then in endemic areas, the interpretation of antibody titers, it may prove difficult. एंडेमिक एरियाज में एंटीबॉडी टाइटर्स में प्रूफ डिफिकल्ट, बट नॉर्मली जो अनवैक्सीनेटेड एनिमल्स हैं उनमें यू कैन गो फॉर स्पेसिफिक डिमॉन्स्ट्रेशन ऑन डायग्नोसिस बाय वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन टेस्ट और ELISA. बट डू रिमेंबर ELISA इज योर प्रेफर्ड सीरोलॉजिकल और द मोस्ट सूटेड और गोल्ड योर गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड टेस्ट फॉर द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ FMD वायरस, दैट्स ELISA. देन आई गेस विल कीप इट टिल हेयर फॉर टुडे. And we'll continue with this with the control of FMD in your next lecture, and we'll discuss another important member of this family, Picorna viridi, in your next lecture. So we'll keep it till here for today. Till then, we'll meet in the next lecture. Till then, take care and have a nice day.